Okay. Hi guys. I don't like the light. Hi guys. Welcome back to my channel. Last week I uploaded this video talking about quarantine and corona and my exams and everything. Thank you so much for the support and your comments and your DMs. I wasn't expecting that kind of response to the video, and I'm so thankful for everyone who commented and sent me a DM and everything. This week's video is a how I study video. It's more like close to my normal content. So a lot of people ask me how I study for ETH, what do we do here, how does the system work. I'm gonna take you through like the semester, the material we're given, how I deal with the material and what I do with it, then exams. So if you're interested in like how I study for ETH, keep on watching. Just a disclaimer, I'm not saying this is the right way to study. I'm not saying this is the only way to study. This is just how I study. I passed most of my exams. I failed a couple of my exams. It's not like a bulletproof way of studying, but I don't know. This is like the main things that I know that people do here that I do. Let's get into it. Every class we have is divided into two things. The one thing is the lecture, which is like 2 hours or 4 hours every week, depends on the workload. And another thing we have is the exercises or tutorials. In the lecture, the professor is explaining material of the class and like the theory and everything. And in the tutorials or exercises, older students who have already taken the class and have good grades in it, they revise the material of the lecture and they help students solve exercises based on the material. Yeah, this is what happens every week, a lecture and the tutorial exercise, and this gets repeated. So during the lecture, some professors usually work with PowerPoint slides, which are given to the students either before or after the lecture. I personally prefer the professors who give us the slides before the lecture, because I got myself an iPad in my first year and it's one of my best purchases, to be honest, because I can just have the slides on my iPad and take notes right next to the slide, and I don't have to like write down everything that I see on the board. I already have it in here, so I just take notes next to my professor's notes, if that makes sense. Except for the PowerPoint slides, some professors also have scripts, which is like a little book. And normally they give us a script in an electronic form. I either keep it on my iPad and work on it on my iPad, but I usually prefer printing the script out and having it in like a physical form so that I can highlight things and take notes on the script. And this specific script, it's a script for fluid dynamics 1 and 2, and we were allowed to have it in the exam for fluid dynamics 2, so that was also a reason why I printed it out. Some other professors sell us the script like that. They print it out themselves, they bind it, and then they sell us the script. Yeah, so this is usually how the lectures work. And then during the exercises, we get the series, the exercises right before the tutorial class, the exercise class, and we can have a look at them and like prepare ourselves for the exercises. And during the actual exercise class, you solve the exercises with the help of the teaching assistant. Usually the exercises are more than the time we have to solve them during the exercise class, so you also have like plenty of exercises to solve on your own. For me personally, I can never solve the exercises on my own. I always wait for the solutions to come out and then I try to like understand what's happening in the exercises. Most of the professors are advising us not to do that, like not look at the solutions, just start solving the exercise yourself, and then after you're done or after you're stuck on the exercise, look at the solutions. But normally during the semester, I have no idea what's going on and I can't even like start solving the exercise on my own. This is the only way it works for me. So after we have our lectures and our exercise, and you're done with your class for the week. So what I do is I go through the notes I've taken during my class and I read through the script chapter in order to understand the theory. And after I've understood the theory, I solve the exercises. And I solve the exercises on paper. I don't know why, but I prefer solving the exercises on paper so that I have like a better feeling. Also, the exams are on paper, so I kind of prepare myself for solving the exam. I don't know if it makes sense. And then I store all of one semester's material in one folder. This is for the whole semester, like all of my semester classes. It's not only for one class. I would die if this was for one class, but yeah. So this is what I do during the semester every week. Keep repeating the same ritual. And then we come to the most dreadful time of the year, exams. Before exams, we have a little bit of time to study. During summer, it's that time to study, it's June and July. During winter, it's 1 month from Christmas to the end of January. And during that time, this time is called Lernphase, like the learning, studying phase. And during this time, I revise the notes, the script, the exercise I've already solved. I solved some exercises that I skipped through the semester, which is usually always the case because I don't have enough time during the semester to solve all of the exercises. Most of the professors give us all the exams that we can practice with, which is the most helpful thing because you can tell how the exam is structured. You can get a feeling of what the professor is asking for, what you should study exactly. Solving all the exams during the studying period and the exam period is the most important thing for us in the bachelor's. I don't know what's happening in the master's. Also, during most exams, we're allowed to have a cheat sheet, like in German it's called Zusammenfassung. It's a summary of like the formulas and some theory that you're allowed to have with you. Most professors say we're allowed to have like 4 pages, like 4 A4 pages with us, with our own notes. Some professors allow you to have more pages. Some professors don't allow you to have a summary at all. Some professors even allow you to have an exam open book and like have all of your notes and all of your exercises and everything on you. That's not usually the case in the bachelor's. That's very rare, but usually the exams that are open book are the most difficult ones. What most people do is they find a Zusammenfassung, a summary of an older student. We can find this online or we can ask like older friends for such things. You're supposed to start working with your summary from the beginning of the semester, like solving your exercises with the help of your summary from the beginning of the semester, so that you know where exactly the material you're looking for is on your summary, and to have like a feeling where you should look, how much time you should spend looking at your summary and stuff like that. Because ETH exams, you never have enough time to solve the whole thing. You're always rushing through the exams, so it's pretty important to use your summary during the semester or during your study phase. So some things that I did wrong, and I know that they were wrong while I was studying, is that sometimes I didn't have enough time during the semester to solve the series, the exercises. So now I'm in the studying phase and I haven't solved some exercises, and I just read through the solutions, which this is bad, and you don't really get a feeling of how you should solve the exercise if you just read through the solutions, because you should like work on it. Even if you look at the solutions, try to like write everything down step by step. What I'm trying to do is I try to explain to myself why I take the step, what's the reasoning behind the step. So this is given from the exercise, that's why I do the specific step. That's really helpful, and like I usually take notes on like the border of the paper, or like I use post-its and I explain to myself why I did this specific step and why it will help in the next steps. And now that everything's online, it's a bit hard for me to concentrate, and I always get headaches at night because I've been sitting all day long on the computer and looking at the screen. So this company reached out to me and they sent me some of their stuff. The company's name is TIJN Eyewear and Sunwear. I was already looking in purchasing some blue light filter glasses because I've been getting these horrible headaches at night and I wouldn't be able to sleep. So this company asked me if I want them to send me some glasses to try out, and this video isn't sponsored, they just sent me the stuff, so I've been happy with them, so I'm just showing them to you. I've never worn glasses because my eyesight has been good enough. This is the pair I chose. I will put the name on the screen. And I usually wear them once the sun goes down and I'm still on my computer trying to do work. I really feel like my eyes can't focus and they're getting tired, so that's why when I put them on. And I use them on my computer, my iPad, my phone. I don't know why, but I also get that feeling that I'm like professional putting on my glasses and focusing on my work. I feel book smart when I wear my glasses, okay? They also sent me a second pair, which was so kind of them, and also a pair of sunglasses, which are so cute. And they also sent me some colored contact lenses, which I haven't tried out. I should, but I'm too scared because I've never like tried out lenses, but I'm excited to try them out actually and see how my eyes look. I always wanted to have a different eye color because my eyes are brown, which is pretty basic, so yeah, I've always wished I had a different eye color. This is the whole process, how I study during the semester, during exams. Yeah, good luck with your studies, everyone. Have a nice start in the new semester. It's already the second week. So thank you for watching and I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye!